4, 3, 2.
Hey, Cougars.
I'm Penny, and today is Tuesday, August 31st, 2021.
And I'm Claire, and it's Red Day.
Please rise and join us for the pledge. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
For today's lunch, we have baked chicken or banana bread or beef fiesta pizza.
The premium meal is shrimp poppers or deli bar. The premium meal is Cuban sandwich.
The sides are mashed potatoes and gravy, caprese salad, fresh melon, and a tossed salad. Speaking of lunch, don't forget.
Please make sure you are wearing your ID when you go through the lunch line so it is quicker and easier for all of us.
Plus, the quicker you get through, the more time you'll have to catch up with your friends.
Hey guys, it's joke time. Do you have one?
Well, duh, I always do. Why do we tell athletes to break a leg?
I have no clue. Why?
Because every play has a cast.
Oh my gosh, Penny.
Attention all NJHS members. Your first meeting will be Monday, September 13th from 2:10 to 3:30 in the 100 quad.
You should have received an email with some information, so check your email.
If you did not get an email, see Ms. Pinson in room 115.
Sorry, my phone.
Also, each month we focus on a new character that we should try to practice, model, and hopefully make a habit on in our daily lives.
Oh yeah? What is our character word for August?
Our character word for August is respect, and it means treating others with honor and courtesy.
That's right. Make sure you are using respect in all parts of your life and interacting with others. Listen up, Cougars. Make sure you're grabbing your copy of the new 2021-2022 yearbook. They are on sale for $25 for a back-to-school special.
Yearbooks can be purchased through www.jostens.com. Yearbooks are such a great way to keep all those good memories. This is sure to be another year to remember, so make sure you're getting yours now. Listen up, Cougars. Now that we're back in the swing of things, here's just a reminder for the cost of replacement items in case you lose any of these things.
Lanyards are $3. A replacement ID badge is $5 after your one free reprint.
Plastic badge holders are $1, a planner is $5, and a replacement binder is $3.
It is super important to be prepared for all of your classes, and having these items is key.
If you do find yourself needing any of these items, you will go see Mrs. Mays in the front office for your replacement items.
Listen up, Cougars. There is an easy way to report bullying here at CMS called the Spriggio program, and it is super easy to access.
All you have to do is go to the Congress website, find the Spriggio icon and click on it, and then enter the information.
Please make sure to use this resource if needed, as we want to make sure everyone feels safe coming to school each and every day.
Also, the counselors have a virtual resource for us on the Congress Middle School website. It can be found on the Congress homepage. Go to About Our School, click on the Counseling Office, and choose Park Hill Calming Room.
It has sounds and music, guided meditations, mindfulness/grounding videos, and live animal cameras.
Check it out even after our show. Again, go to the Congress homepage, About Our School, Counseling Office, Park Hill Calming Room. This is such a great way to a resource to pull up from home.
If you are ever absent or happen to forget all of the amazing information we share with you, or you just want to see our amazing faces again, we have an easy fix for you.
That's right. You can subscribe to our amazing YouTube channel and watch this amazing show again. It will help you catch up of any of our shows and get any information you may have missed. And now, a public service announcement from our awesome principal, Dr. Early.
I hope your week has been off to a good start already. I wanted to take just a minute to talk to you about something really, really important, and that is cell phones. I know we all have them, we all love them, we all use them a lot, but at the end of the day, they are a distraction here at school. In the past, when we've used lockers, we've simply made a rule that says all phones must be left in lockers. And it was actually kind of funny. I could walk down the hall in the morning and hear different beeps and sounds as phones went off in lockers, but at least they weren't going off in class. Now, without lockers, we're trusting you to carry your phones on you in a responsible way. And I know your teachers have already gone over this with you, but I want to remind you that phones should be in backpacks at all times. The only time it might be acceptable for you to take your phone out at school is when a teacher basically has a planned activity that might utilize those phones. Like, for example, last week, I know we were doing some scavenger hunts and things like that. Otherwise, the phones do need to be put away. And what you need to understand is there can be consequences for having your phones out. I think our teachers showed a lot of grace with those last year. It was just kind of a weird year, and I think we were a little more lenient about virtually everything. But this year, as we try to get back to normal, I know we're still wearing masks, but we're all back, and it's definitely a little bit more normal than it has been. As we try to get more back to normal, we just want to make sure that phones aren't causing an interruption. So again, they do need to stay in your backpack unless specifically told by a teacher that you can have it out. I think, you know, several of you, when we've talked to you a little bit about phones, often say, well, I'm actually answering a text from mom and dad, and I know that's true. Trust me, I'm 46 years old and I still get texts from my mom, and sometimes I have to say, hey, I'm working here. You may wanna have that talk with mom and dad. You know, Dr. Early said phones are supposed to be put up. I know I will be putting something out about that in the newsletter. I'll be talking to parents about that on our orientation night coming up. We'll try to encourage mom and dad not to text you so much at school, but you need to do your part to make sure that you stay off your phone so you can stay focused. And I think that'll make things smoother for everyone. That's it for now. Have a great day, Cougars.
Thank you for a great reminder, Dr. Early.
Well, that's all we got for today. I'm Penny, and today is Monday, August 31st, 2021.
And I'm Claire, and it's a white day.
After a while, crocodile.